वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाभदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरतिशे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो भक्त्या विहीनाय पराधलक्ष्यै क्षेप्ताश्च कामादितरङ्गमध्ये कृपामयीं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दम् तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञराधे तं नयमां चरणान्तिके श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि श्री गौरभक्त हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
क्या
नाम गुलो बोले दिन ना पहले
चलते दो तुम बोलो। Today we have given some new names to new devotees. We want to declare the new names. First,
we solemnly claim to have
you should stand up.
Hari Mohini.
Oh, Hari Mohini Devi ki jai. I will tell you Hari Mohini Devi. No? Your name has been Hari Mohini. Hari means Krishna. Mohini means who can attract Krishna also. With her, all the good qualification and devotional activities, you can attract Krishna. Then this name will be so much sarthak.
Proper.
Successful. So try to develop.
Terence Jones.
Tarun Kanti. Krishna is Tarun Kanti. So, Tarun Kanti Prabhu ki
jai. Yeah. Yeah.
Now you will be.
Ram Santi.
Rasakalika. Rasakalika Devi ki
jai. Yeah.
Rasakalika means, Kali means bird. But full of rush. What rush? Krishna rush, prema rush, shyama rush. Always full to serve Srimati Radhika. So, Rasya?
Rasakalika.
Rasakalika Devi ki?
Jai.
Shivani.
Oh.
Shyamali.
Now, you will be called as Shyamali. Shyamali Dasi ki
jai.
Shyamali means Shyam mane Krishna. And Shyamali mane Srimati Radhika. So a special Dasi of Radhika is Shyam. No?
Sita.
Who is Sita? Your name is so good. In two ways. Also, very beloved of Sri Ramchandra and also beloved of Sri Advaitacharya. In Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Leela, Sita Devi, beloved of Advaitacharya. And in Ram Leela, Sita, no harm. Manifestation of Srimati Radhika. So you will be called Sita Devi.
Dasi.
सीता दासी, सीता दासी की
करण
करुणामयी दासी, ऑल देवी और दासी एनी ऑल करुणा ऑफ श्रीमती राधिका टुगेदर इन करुणामयी. सो यू आर नाउ टोल्ड एज करुणामयी देवी. करुणामयी देवी की
जन खरले जदुवर दास.
हाँ, जदुवर दास प्रभु, जदुवर दास प्रभु की. वी विल कॉल यू जदुवर. हुई जदुवर. इट सीम्स दैट मोस्ट प्रोमिनेंट इन जदु डायनेस्टी, बट हुई इज कृष्ण हिमसेल्फ. हाउ? बिकॉज नंद महाराज वॉज ऑल्सो इन जदु डायनेस्टी. The father of Nanda Baba has two father of father. Grandfather Parjanya has two wives, one from Jadu and one from Gopis.
Parjanya
ke pitaji. And from there, Nanda Baba came in Jadu Vansha like Nanda Baba. And another hand, in Jadu dynasty, Sursen and Basudev. After his son
Vasudev.
And again that line came in Krishna. Like from Sur dynasty by Vasudev Krishna, Vasudev, and also from Nand, both were Krishna. So Jadvar is Krishna.
Karan Harle.
Where she is? Oh, Hari Bol here.
Kalindi
Devi. Kalindi Devi. Kalindi Devi ki?
Yes.
Very good name. Peter
Bas. Moore.
Peter Moore. Pitambar Das.
Pitambar Das. Very good name. Pitambar Das. Pitambar Das Prabhu ki?
Yes.
Also call him Pitambar. I will call him Pitambar.
Josephine Weller.
Oh?
Josephine Weller.
Ah, yes.
Janavi.
Oh, Janavi Devi. Janavi Dashi. Janavi Dashi ki?
Damodar.
Oh, I got him. Son, very good.
Damodar
Das. Ki? Damodar Brahmachari ki? You should not speak if anyone is not telling you Damodar. Only answer when anyone telling you Damodar Prabhu. We will talk Damodar Prabhu.
He wants to be a Babaji.
No, he will be a Brahmachari. Always serving Vaishnavas and Guru.
Miss Watson. Murali Mohan.
Murali Mohan. Very good. Always playing. Murali Mohan Prabhu ki.
Yes.
I joined with him in 84, and yes. Now he's coming to you.
Yes. Yes. All?
Yes.
Today is Ekadashi Vrata. I think that most of you have observed Ekadashi. To observe Ekadashi fully, like the king Ambarish Maharaj, is very rare. We should try. But we are Kali Yugi. He was in Satyayu. So he was so strong. he could have fasted till 1 year, he may, without sleep, standing on one leg, without water, without air, he can. But we cannot. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and mercifully he told that you can take something if you are so much hungry. You can take some fruits, some juice, milk, sugar candy, like this. But don't take again in minute and minutes. Not that we took 1 kilo of juice, and after half an hour we took mango juice, 1 kilo. After that same half an hour we took so many boiled potato, so many with so many things. After half an hour again, so much water and so much pakodi. Oh, after that, chena, you know?
Cheese.
About half a kilo with so much sugar.
This is fast.
You know rabdi?
Yeah.
In India. Then half kilo rabdi. Oh, it is not a kalsi.
Feasting.
Yes, not all these things. To keep our life, we should take something so that sleepiness, idleness and anything should not come. And we should try to not to sleep in night also, not in day and night, and also in night, chanting, remembering, associating, like
Ambarish Maharaj.
He was a householder person. He was the emperor of whole world, so much entangled in worldly things, from outwardly we see. And we see in the other hand, a Brahmin who was very realized yogi, like Durvasa. If he tells anyone that you should die, he will at once die. If a dead person is there, he will tell, oh, come on. He will arise. He can do anything. And also Brahman, Brahmarshi, Brahmavadi, Advaitavadi he was at first. He was thinking that I have come in a Brahmin kul and I am in the dynasty of Shankar. Shankar ka wo kya hai? Manifestation of Shankar. Son of Atri and
Anushyadmi.
Very learned and very good quality of Bhagavata. Uttam Mahabhagavata. Also the teacher of Sita Devi, himself Lakshmi. And he was son. Thinking that I am greatest man in this world. I can do anything in a moment. But he did not use to observe Ekadasi. So when Ambarish Maharaj was there, in Mathura, observing Mahadvadasi, like this today, taking nothing, no water, no tea, nothing, observed himself in chanting, remembering, serving deities, praying, doing all these things, whole day, whole night. Next day, he has worshipped Krishna and he was ready to take some prasadam.
As a param.
Next day. Same moment that Rishi, Durvasa Rishi came. He was like God. But not observing Ekasi. He was realized Brahmavadi. He can do anything. Ambarish Maharaj prayed him that you should take today Mahadvapsi Paran here and then I will take anything. He told, yes, I am going to take bath in Jamuna very nearby and come in just now. But he delayed so much that the time of Paran was going on. Only 1, 2, 3 minutes was there. Ambarish was thinking what to do. In one hand, a Brahmin Rishi, not ordinary, he is Siddha Mahayogi, and he has come to my door. I should first
respect him
by giving Mahaprasadam, then I should take. If I am not doing, then I am disobeying Indian culture. I must obey. But by this, it may be that I may get to hell. But in other hand, I have to object my Ekadasi. It is not a worldly thing. It is paramarthic. Paramarthic means?
Transcendental.
If I am losing, dishonoring Mahadvadashi, not taking in proper time something, Mahaprasadam, not serving, then I will lose my
devotion, bhakti.
Bhakti, devotion, I will lose. So, what to do? Honor to this Brahmin or honor to bhakti? He decided at loss. I should honor bhakti. I cannot lose bhakti. I cannot do anything against bhakti. Whether I should, I am losing anything, worldly thing. I am going to hell, no harm. But I should not disrespect Ekadasi. So I must take something within time and observe Ekadasi fully. So he took some water, Charanamritam of Krishna. He has worshipped with Tulsi. There was some water, Charanamrit of Krishna. He took only one drop of our water. If anyone has observed Ekadasi without any fruit, without juice, without water, next day he can take Paranam by that Charanamrit. But anyhow, one has taken fruit, juice and all, milk or anything, or water even, he will have to take some grain, prasadam. Otherwise his Ekadasi is not full. So he thought that I have not taken anything, fasting, not taking water also, 24 hours. So I can take Charanamrita and Ekadasi will be full. And in the meantime, the Brahmin will come and also I will respect. So both will be observed. So he took, when a drop of Charanamritam, at once, suddenly that Rishi Durvasa came and told, I have none, you. I know you. You are a only show bottle for
devotee.
Show car. I am a Brahmin, I am a Siddha Brahman. You know my father and mother, you know my all powers. Even you have dishonored me, I will burn you into ashes. He took one
hair.
Yeah.
Not hair, but jata.
Jata,
you know?
Dreadlocks.
He took and put it on the earth at all. Oh, at once be fire. Burning fire. At once it is set, the shape of burning fire, and she ran to make ashes to Ambarish Maharaj. At once Chakra Sudarshan appeared there. You should always make a very good note that Krishna has ordered his Sudarshan Chakra, his weapon, that always save and protect Vaishnavas, Bhakta, those who have taken shelter to me. At once Sudarshan came and he burned to ashes to that fire.
Dead demon.
Demon. That demon. Who was in the shape of burning fire. And he ran at and followed Durvasa Rishi. Durvasa Rishi kept his legs on his head and fled from there. Oh, Shammi, Shammi, Shammi. Durvasa, when this fire was coming to Ambarish Maharaj, he never feared. He was like this. Oh, Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna. No fear at all. He was so much out of fear, but nirbhaya.
Fearless.
If I will die, no harm. If I am saved, no harm. It depends on my Krishna. So he left everything on Krishna. And at once Chakshur Darshan came and saved him. And he ran after Durvasa Rishi. But Durvasa Rishi, being a Brahman, so realized, yogi and so much powerful, but yet he was fearing from death. And he ran. He did not stop. He went at once to his father, like Shiva. She saw that he is coming running. Oh, don't come here. Go from here. I know why you are running. Don't come. You have disobeyed Vaishnavas. I know the influence of Vaishnavas. I am also fearing from them. If I will get shelter, you, I will be also cut by Sudarshan Chakra. He will learn, never give up. So he went to Brahma. Brahma told, oh, don't come to me. Then anyhow he went to Vishnu. And prayed that, oh Vishnu, save me from your weapon. I have come to your
shelter.
He told him, I cannot do anything. I have no freedom. I have given my all freedom to my bhakt. Though I have given their hearts to me, I have also given heart to them. If there is a thorn coming into the finger of feet, it will not come out, take out from the head. What is the meaning? If anything, thorn is going in the feet, lower part of the feet, we cannot take it from head.
Yeah.
We'll have to take it from feet. Understand this?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So my feet are Vaishnavas. My heart are Vaishnavas. My everything is Vaishnavas. Aham bhakta paradhino. Yes. It is my pratigya.
Promise.
I have promised like so. So I cannot do. If you want to be set, at once go to that Ambarish Maharaj. Don't think that he is family man, and he is a king, and he is nothing, and he is Kshatriya. Go at once. He is my heart. You don't think that he is a very sadharan person.
Ordinary
person. Bhakta Janapriya. Worldly persons think like this. Oh, I am so learned. I am so rich. I am so powerful. And this bogus Vaishnava, only chanting Hare Krishna, doing nothing. But you should not behave like this. Be Vaishnava, actually, sincere. And Krishna will certainly save you, protect you, give Krishna prem. At once he returned to Ambarish Maharaj. Ambarish Maharaj was apologizing very, very
politely.
Trinadapi Sunij. Oh, I'm nothing. I'm not devotee. I have disobeyed you. I've taken something. So be merciful to you. And he was coming and falling on the lotus feet of Ambarish Maharaj. Oh, Ambarish Maharaj ran after him and took in his hands. Arms. He had not taken anything. A drop of water since 1 year. Then he told that be merciful and take Mahaprasadam here. He told that save me from that Sudarshan is following me and I am burning. Then he told that, oh Prabhu, Seth, if I have done any service to Krishna, then Seth this Brahmin. At once Sudarshan became very so cool, and he returned and disappeared. Then he told that, oh, now I think that who are bhakts? Very powerful, more than Krishna himself. Krishna has given his all power to Vaishnava. But they hide all these things. They cheat others that I am nothing, like Trinada Vishunich. But now I am realizing how powerful Vaishnava are. And how they are generous, and how they are polite, and how they think themselves very deenhi, humble. Then he prayed that you should take Mahaprasadam. Then he gladly took Mahaprasadam, and after that, with family, his whole, Ambarish Maharaj took Prasad. So be like that. Also humble, but so strong in faith and devotional activity to Krishna and for this Ekadashi. We can give our head, life and soul to observe Ekadashi. Ekadashi will protect and seize the mother of Prema Bhakti. Bhakti Vinod Thakur has told, Madhavatithi Bhakati Janani. See, Madhavatithi, it is called Madhavatithi. The mother of Bhakti, Prema Bhakti. So we should try as pure as we can. Don't take so many times. Even water, so many juice, so many things, full stomach. Very little. Once, or if you cannot, why you cannot, if we so old persons, very lean and thin person, we can without water we can live, why you can?
Young,
strong, strong, you can do. So try to follow, okay? Okay, very good. But, not taking anything and head is paining, sleepiness coming, idleness coming, but no use. Try to remember Krishna, try to associate Vaishnava, reading books, praying Krishna. He Krishna Karuna Sindho, Dina Bandho Jagatpate, Gopesha Gopika Kanda. Radha Kanda, like so, always day and night. So we must observe Ekadashi like this. Very power it gives, so much power that Brahma Gyan, Brahma Jog Samadhi cannot give. First thing. One kirtan, little. Any English song you can do? You have made?
I don't have any prepared.
No. Not prepared.
I don't remember any.
Yes. Oh, you forget here.
Namami Nanda Nandanam.
Namami Nanda Nandanam. Namami Nanda Nandanam.
You should try to learn this song and do everywhere.
Namami Nanda Nandanam.
Normal. All.
All.
then we should come to this subject, which was I'm explaining from Chaitanya Charitamrita, so important. I recited one sloka of Krishna Karanamritam by Bilvamangal Thakur. Chintamanir Jayati. Som Girir me Siksha Guruschu Sikipancha Mauli. Yat Pad Kalpa Pallava Pallava Sukharesu Lila Swayambhav Rasa Labhate Jayasri. He has begun Mangalacharan doing of his book. Very important. First, he is doing pranam to the that lady, Chintamani, who has given some way to come towards Krishna. And then to his guru, or the meaning of Chintamani, jate guru e Chintamani. No here explanation of Chintamani, that. But guru is himself Chintamani. He gives Krishna. Or third meaning is that Krishna is himself Chintamani. And he is like Somgiri. He is Shiksha Guru. Also. How beautiful his Shiksha Guru is. Have him pick a feather here. 3/4 from here. Here. Feathers. 3/4 here. 3/4 here. Very sweet singing. To whom? His lotus feet are like kalpa vriksha. Kalpa means?
Desire
tree.
Wishfuling tree.
And in feeds, in that desire tree, his this part feeds are like leaves, pallava. And in these fingers are the like very shining, very beautiful. And the last end of the fingers,
nail.
This nail.
Fingertip.
Nail. More beautiful than Chandra Kiran.
Moon rays.
Very beautiful. Very sweet, very fragrant. The rays are coming from the nails. And upon these rays, Srimati, that is Lila Swayambhar Rasa Jayasri. Jayasri means Srimati Radhika. Gives her heart, everything, life and soul, and does aarti by this to the rays of nails. Like lakhs and lakhs pran, mana life, she is doing aarti and feeling the same happiness, joy, like Swayambhara. What is the meaning of Swayambhara?
Marriage ceremony where you pick your husband.
Huh?
Marriage ceremony where you pick your husband.
Not like this, like something. I'm telling a story like of Swayambhara of Krishna. No. Once Draupadi met all the queens of Krishna, Satyabhama, Rukmini, Lakshmana and all, in Kurukshetra, and they were discussing each other. Draupadi told to the queens, how you got a husband like Krishna. You are so fortunate. One of them, Lakshmana, was telling his own history, how he came in contact of Krishna. She was a very darling daughter of his king father, very big. And he saw that this darling daughter is so beautiful, marvelous in whole world. So I will give this to only anyone who is qualified, so beautiful, so having all qualities in whole world. He should be powerful, beautiful, having all the qualities. So he made a program. He gave a very big, high pillar in the earth. No? Understand? Very long pillar. Tall pillar in the earth. It was so high. On the top, he managed that a chakra was moving.
Disc. Moving wheel.
Moving wheel there was.
Disc.
And after that, there was a fish, artificial. And fishes has two
eyes.
In eyes, they have some
red.
Pupils. Black. The chakra was moving. No? He told king, promise that if anyone seeing lower down in a pot there is a water, in seeing water
reflection.
And if seeing here by his
arrows
like this, if he'll shoot the black
people
of the fish, then he will merit my daughters. All Indians are world's champions, shooters,
archers.
They came there. They were all invited. Karna was invited, Duryodhana was, Jarasandha, Shishupal, Krishna, Baladev, Arjun, all were invited. All they were prepared and thinking that I will do it, and so beautiful this girl I will marry. Arjun was also coming. Dronacharya also came. Bhisham Pitamaha also came. All came. Bhisham Pitamaha and Drona thinking that if I will
shoot it,
then this girl should be married to Duryodhana. Like this. Karna wanted to marry this girl. Arjun, even Bhim, Nakul, Sahadev, all wanted to marry this girl. Oh, so beautiful. All were there. They were practicing or they are shooting. Bhim came, Duryodhana came, Shishupal came. They cannot see whether this fish was in the water. They cannot. So they gave up their dhanush.
Bow.
Karna came. He shot the fish. But he could not aim. He also kept his bow. Then all were hopeless. Then Arjun came very boldly and he was seeing this shadow and he saw that on the chakra in the right eyes he has to shoot. He aimed but it touched only the lower part of the fish. tell Balkalmer short. Then Krishna came and took the bow. And in a second, and you could not see when he took his bow and when he suited it, and at once the fish suited in his right eyes, pupils, and she came down. Then I became so overjoyed, Lakshmana is telling. I became so overjoyed. My sakhis gave me garland in my hand to give it in the neck of Krishna. To select bridegroom. Barko. To select a bridegroom among lakhs and lakh person, this is called Swayambara. In India it was. So lakhs and lakhs, all Rajkumar, son of kings, were there, so beautiful, so all this. But at first he wanted, he has heard something about Krishna, and she has given her heart to Krishna before. So he wanted to marry Krishna, but he was hopeless. Now he saw that Krishna has M, and she became overjoyed. This became. He could not stand. She was trembling somewhat. And she began to see down. But her eyes were looking crookedly towards Krishna. And Krishna, he always wants that. He was always searching very beautiful girls. So he was also peeping like this. And she was so overjoyed. And she became so happy. He could not raise her hands. The Sakhi helped her to raise her hands and to weave garland. So he was becoming like senseless, overjoyed. So this is the happiness of that time. So Srimati Radhika becomes as joyful to serve like the nails raise and become so happy always. But Prabodhanand Saraswati or our group is not satisfied by that. Rup Goswami's group tells her, no, it is not. Krishna should do like this and he should be happy and he should pray for this. So he is telling, but Bansi karannipatitam skhalitam sikhandam brashtam chapita basanam brajaraja sunu jasya kataksha sarghat vimurchitasya tangratika parichirami kadarasena. He is telling opposite. Once Krishna is going to cause grace, and Srimati Radhika is peering him from the corner of any very beautiful groves. Krishna at once saw Srimati Radhika. When he saw towards the eyes of Srimati Radhika, crooked, this like bow, coming something from the eyes of Srimati Radhika, he at once became
senseless.
Uncontrolled. Flute came from his, dropped on the earth from his hands. He could not control. His peacock feather here, it also fell down the earth. He could not control. And he was becoming senseless, trembling. Madhumangal at the same time knocked him and told, oh friend, why, what you are doing? Your father Nanda Baba is here, Yashoda Maiya here, so many persons are here, and you doing like so? Be careful. He did like so. He came in senses. So I want to serve this Srimati Radhika, by the smell of Radhika. Not a smell of it, buddy. Buddy smell comes in well of Srimati Radhika. And air takes it from bells and goes to Krishna. Krishna becomes uncontrolled.
Radhika.
No? So Radhika is so much higher. His love and affection is so much higher. We want this. Though Billo Mangal Thakur is like Krishna's superiority, but we, Rupa Goswami, Prabodhananda Saraswati, Raghunath Das Goswami, we in the line want that Krishna should be defeated in all way by Srimati Radhika. And it becomes like so. So here, he is praying to Krishna that he is Siksha Guru. Krishna is Siksha Guru. What kind of Siksha Guru? Chaitya Guru. And sometimes he becomes himself Siksha Guru. If Siksha Guru is not formed, he himself becomes. For Arjuna, he became himself Guru. For Guru, for Gopis, he became himself Guru. And he made Gurus to Gopis himself also. So Krishna is so merciful. If you pray, it will not go in vain. This is the first duty of devotees, that have faith in Krishna. Like Billo Mangal, like Rupa Goswami. Sometimes Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami are talking each other the glories of Radha and Krishna. Srimati Radhika saw that they have not taken anything. It is about 12. He came in the shape of any
young girl.
Not young girl.
Teenage girl.
Kishori. And told, you have not made anything. You are fasting. My mother has given some milk and rice and some sugar. You should make an kheer and you should take. But they have no time to make it. Oh, you have no time, I am making. So anyhow, you see, managed. She brought some cow dungs, dry, and from his hands, from by fire came. And in a moment she did very beautiful, tasteful kheer. He told, oh, Rupa Goswami, give it to your brother, and also you should take, you should offer it to your Ishtadev, and then you can take. Now Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami walked. Oh, who was that girl? Rupa Goswami, have you told to pray to your Radhika? No, I have not prayed. But she came and did all these things. She tested how beautiful this Krishna Prasad. They tested something and became weeping loudly. We have lost the moment. You have disappeared. We cannot do pranam. We cannot serve you. We have given you so much
trouble
that you have cooped yourself. Rope, don't do anything in future like this. So, how marvelous their devotion is. Try to follow. Hearing this, remembering these pastimes, we should try to serve Radha and Krishna conjugal. So he is telling now, he has told five, only bhaktas are remaining. Guru is the roop of Krishna. Siksha Guru is the swarup of Krishna, same thing. Each other, no down, no high.
Equal.
Sometimes Siksha Guru may be superior, sometimes Diksha Guru may be. But all are like liberated of Uttam Adhikari. So, now he is telling about bhakts. Ishwar Swarup Bhakta Tar Adhishtha. Diksha Guru and Siksha Guru, same as Krishna, manifestation of Krishna. But all the bhakts, you don't think ordinary. They are abode of Krishna. They are asan, basan and asaya for Krishna. Everything. Krishna can take rest there. Because their heart is always pure. No worldly desire there. No feelings, any kinds of sorrow, suffering. Because no problem at all. They don't want Krishna anything like Rup Sanatan. So Krishna take rest there. He sleeps thoroughly, very peacefully. Karmi, Jnani, Yogi has so many desires, so they tell, oh, Krishna gave me a very beautiful lady. Oh, Krishna, I have no son. Oh, Krishna, I want liberation. Oh, Krishna, I want mukti. So all these things. But Krishna, devotee, don't want anything for their own. If they want, they want bhakti, to serve more and more Krishna. So, we should know that all these Sikhs are Krishna himself, but always also for Vilas they are in Sikhs. So, Bhed and Aved both are there.
Difference and non-difference.
Oneness and difference. Both are there. At the same time. Yes. This is called Achinta Bheda Bheda. Then he is telling Tattva Vidas Tattam Jajjnanam Advayam Brahmeti Paramatmeti Bhagavaneti Shabdate. Tattati. You can read the meaning.
Which verse?
Vadanti tattavidastattva.
Vadanti tattavidastattva.
What number?
He is telling who is Krishna.
Kun number diya sachitva.
Kaun number? Which verse number?
Oh, in two chapter.
Chapter 2.
11.
Chapter 11.
Chapter 2, 11.
Learned transcendentalists who know the absolute truth say that it is non-dual knowledge and is called impersonal Brahman, localized Paramatma, and the personality of Godhead, purport. This Sanskrit verse appears as the 11th verse in the first canto, second chapter of Srimad Bhagavatam, where Suta Goswami answers the questions of the sages headed by Shonaka concerning the essence of all scriptural instructions. Tattva Vidu refers to persons who have knowledge of the absolute truth. They can certainly understand knowledge
like Narada, Vedavyas, Brahma, Shankar, Sukadeva Goswami, they are all tattvavi. Knowing the essence of all the Vedas scriptures, they are tattvavi. They can realize the essence of all these things. So they tell what?
They can certainly understand knowledge without duality because they are on the spiritual platform. The absolute truth is known sometimes as Brahman, sometimes as Paramatma, and sometimes as Bhagavan. Persons who are in knowledge of the truth know that one who tries to approach the absolute simply by mental speculation will ultimately realize the impersonal Brahman. And one who tries to approach the absolute truth through yoga practice will be able to realize Paramatma. But one who has complete knowledge and spiritual understanding realizes the spiritual form of Bhagavan, the personality of Godhead. Devotees of the personality of Godhead know that Sri Krishna, the son of the king of Braj, is the absolute truth. They do not discriminate between Sri Krishna's name, form, quality, and pastimes. One who wants to separate the Lord's absolute name, form, and qualities must be understood to be lacking in absolute knowledge. A pure devotee knows that when he chants the transcendental name Krishna, Sri Krishna is present as transcendental sound.
Stop something. One thing you remember. Ja Bhagavat Pada. Yes. Don't try to know anything by books. Everything is in book. Everything is in Srimad Bhagavatam. Everything was in Ved. Everything was or is Vedanta. Everything in Srimad Bhagavat, everything in Chaitanya Charitamrita, and everything in the book of Swamiji. But law and key, very powerful law and key is there. You cannot know by yourself because you are not so qualified. You must take help. Go to Vaishnavas. Bhagavat. Ja Bhagavat pada Vaishnavarasthana. There are two kinds of Bhagavat. One Bhagavat, this Grantha, but lock and key in, and another are Bhagavat Vaishnava. Bhakta Bhagavat. Realized soul. So go to them and then read Chaitanya Chaitamrita Srimad Bhagavat and his books also, Swamiji. Then you will see, oh, very beautiful. Ocean of rush is in this book. We cannot do. So always try to be with higher rank of devotees, and there in their association we can know the meanings. You can read so many times. I think that so many devotees have read this, but they have felt, they have fallen down. Why? They could not take the essence and they cannot follow. I know that all the devotees, perhaps in ISKCON, they have read all these things, but very hard to realize all these things. So we must go to Vaishnava. Realize Bhagavat. This Bhagavat will give the essence of Bhagavat. Two Bhagavats. This Grantha Bhagavat and then Bhakta Bhagavat. Go to Bhagavat. They are so generous.
So merciful.
More than Srimad Bhagavatam. If you go to them, then they will realize the mercy of Srimad Bhagavat and Krishna. Otherwise we cannot have. So this Vadanti Tattva Vidas Tattvam. Try to listen very attentively and try to take it in your heart. Vadanti Tattva Vidaha. Those who know the Tattva, like Narad, like Vyas, like Shankar, like Shanak Shanandana Sanatan, like Rupa Goswami, like all others, they have made a conclusion. They have taken the essence of the tattva. Advaya, gyan is paratattva. What is advaya gyan? Without him, in this whole world, nothing is separate. Nothing is swadhin.
Independent.
Without that truth, fundamental truth, in this world, किसी की सत्ता स्वाधीन रूप में अलग से नहीं है. There is no
entity
without him.
Separate.
Free. Understand? We all are subordinate from Baladev, and to end all avatars, all gods, all demigods, this universe, an ant, anything, no separate existence.
The blade of grass is separate.
Huh?
But the blade of grass is separate.
Yes. All depends on Krishna. So only one fundamental truth is Krishna. All are his subordinates. We are also, Maya is also, grass is ants, and everything dependent on Krishna. So in this whole world, in whole universe, on all universe, in Golok, Vrindavan, in Vaikuntha, no, there is nothing, anyone whose entity is separate, independent. Only Krishna. All which we see, this is the manifestation of his three shakti, three power. Chit shakti, jiva shakti, and maya shakti. Shankar is not, Shankar or any demigods is not independent. Baldev Prabhu is also not dependent, independent. Anyone. Srimati Radhika, power of Krishna. Lakshmi, all the manifestation of Radhika. We all in this world, material, maya, and soul with jiva shakti. So everything in Krishna, universe in unity in
diversity.
Everything. Everywhere Krishna. So tattvavid see that this fundamental truth, absolute truth, is Krishna. He had not name, but only Bhagavan. Those who see this absolute truth by jnana, by knowledge, they see Brahma. What is that Brahma? Only the some beauty of the nail of the Krishna. No shape, nothing there. This is called Brahma. And a very part of Sat and Chit of Krishna is called Paramatma here in all. He is also not independent. He is a very small fraction, last fraction of Krishna, but not independent. So everything, there is nothing else in this world, anywhere, whose independence is there. No? So Krishna is called Adhaya Jnana Paratattva, everything in Krishna. But who is that Bhagavan? Ete Chansa Kala Punsa Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. Krishna is that, but
Supreme
Personality of Godhead. Supreme Personality of Absolute Truth. So tattvavid knows like this. In Srimad Bhagavata, everywhere it has been told. In other epics it has been told. Krishna Paramah Krishna Vigra Anadiradi Govindaha. And his manifestation is Baldev Prabhu in Braja. He is not other than Krishna. He is himself Krishna, but in other shape. He is golden color and Krishna is in black color. Very beautiful, Shyam. No? But both are same. From Baldev Prabhu, Mul Sankarsan, Maha Sankarsan, Mahavishnu, Karnabdhi Sai, Garbhodhi Sai, Khirobdhi Sai, Shesh, all has come out. And this world, all has come out. So Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Absolute Truth. He is Krishna. That Krishna is coming down here as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And his supreme power, Srimati Radhika, coming in the shape of Gadadhar. That Krishna, after his pastime of Dwapar, he was thinking that even creepers, trees, all were charmed to me. All. I have given so much pure devotion to all. Without Krishna, anyone cannot do this. Yugdharma can come from Mahavishnu, Advaita Acharya. This is the function of
Mahavishnu.
But Krishna praying cannot be given by anyone except Krishna. Only Prabhu never gives. He keeps it for Krishna. So, it has been told here that very Krishna who can give love, devotion to all, he took the beauty and shape of color of Srimati Radhika and became Gaurachandra. Why? Just 1 minute. Why he took? Because he is so kind. He is unparalleled, merciful, causeless merciful. And he is the ocean of rush. He wanted to test three desires his own. And to bestow some of this Krishna prem to jivas, which has never given in a very long period in Brahma one day. And that has been told in Anarpita Charin Chirat Karunayava Tirana Kalo Samarapaitam Unnatva Jalara Sang Swabhakti Siyam Hari Hapurat Sundara Dut Kadamba Sandipita Sadaridaya Kamba. Come in third chapter. I will try to explain it tomorrow. Very deep meaning. All the mercies are in this sloka of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Causeless mercy. Try to take the essence of this sloka and be very beautiful, qualified devotee. Otherwise, only chanting will not do. Chanting will help you. And it will make your chanting so much advanced. So we should chant. But with these modes, then we can progress, otherwise not. Perhaps you have marked that. Mayabadi also chant Hare Krishna, and they go to hell. Karmi is also doing chanting and involved in worldly things. They get money, name and fame, everything by that. So, if you are doing Harinam chanting in the guidance of so beautiful, qualified Guru and Vaishnava, then your chanting will be so high class. Otherwise he will give anything, this name will give the anything, and he will cheat you and he will go away. So you should try to take the essence of this thing. Don't miss your classes. Try to attend classes shortly. That's great. Anything to?
Yes. Tomorrow the you can take will be at the house of Nikola Devidasi. And your husband?
I'm going to write down a notice and to read it.
Okay.
I think most people know.
His room is so big.
Yes,
Noah.
But all should know that we all go there tomorrow. And
what time?
Time is at 5:30, 5 o'clock. Uh-huh. Kirtan starts.
Half hour kirtan?
Yes.
And then from 6 I will do my class.
All are welcome.
They will take prasadam there also.
Mahaprasad will also be taken there. Everything will be taken there.
I'd also like to make an announcement. I'm in charge of selling Gurudev's books, and we have four varieties to choose from. And I would invite all devotees, if you haven't seen the books, to come and talk to me and about prices and other things. You can talk to me after the program. And the reason why I got it now is because sometimes people disperse after this program or during Arati, and I want to make sure that everybody knows that I'm selling these books and that they are available, even if you don't see them now. So please talk to myself or Ram Vijay Prabhu, the birthday boy, about the books. I thought when we came down under, we'd do really well.
Can you ask questions?
Huh? Can you answer a question?
Not this time. Okay. When I'm easy in there. In the morning, they can.
Or
in the morning? People.
Huh?
You can manage one day only to ask questions and to answer.
Yes.
Day after tomorrow, I shall continue this.
Yes.
I don't want to disturb it. Very special thing. After this class.
On Friday?
Yes. We can do.
There is also a suggestion from Ras. He wants to invite all the devotees for Harinam. Sankirtan, Nagar Sankirtan.
Yes, I want that you should do Nagar Sankirtan.
Okay, I will organize, but.
Saturday,
because Friday is the Shri Guru Maharaj.
Saturday.
So Saturday, prepare that we're going to have a massive Harinam Sankirtan party. Kija!
A kirtan, you can do. Mahamantra, very beautiful tune. Wait a little, 2 minutes. Sit down. Come on. Sit down. Begin.
Do pranam.
any you.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Ram
Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare
Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Guru Deva, Jaya Guru Deva, Jaya Guru Deva,
Guru Deva, Jaya Narayan Maharaj, Narayan Maharaj, Jaya Narayan Maharaj.
Paramahamsa Parivraja Kacharya Asto Tarasata Shri Shrimad His Divine Grace Shrila Bhakti Pagyan Keshav Goswami Raj Ki Jai Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnu Pad Paramahamsa Parivraja Kacharya Asto Tarasata Shri Shrimad Vaishnava King Namacharya Shrila Haridas Thapo King Prem Sakaho Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shiva Sadi Gunaray Maharaj is Transcendental Book Description Ki Brihat Madanga King Go Prem Anande All glorious to Son of Devotees All glorious to Son of Devotees All glorious.